Please subscribe math.com for any query, comment or email. Hello everyone. In our previous lecture, we have seen how you can multiply the two matrices together. But one thing left is how you will multiply if you are given with the three matrices. For that purpose, we have used the associative law of multiplication that will help to multiply the three matrices together. This law is stated as, if you have three matrices, let's say A, B and C are three matrices, then according to the associative law of multiplication, they will be multiplied together by using the form as like this. Now what does this mean? It means that you can multiply the two matrices together and then the result will be multiplied with the third one. Okay, again you can multiply the second and third matrix together and the result will be multiplied with the third one. So this is how you can multiply the three matrices together if you are given the three matrices, and you can apply the associative law of multiplication over this. First of all, we will see, while multiplication, we have to check the condition whether the given matrices are comfortable for the multiplication or not. We can check it by using the example. Let's have an example. If you are given with the three matrices, example is, okay, these are the three matrices that we are going to multiply by using the associative law of multiplication. Let's write down the form of associative law of multiplication as, we have the two sides. One is the left hand side and the other is the right hand side. Okay, we can use any of them for finding the multiplication of the three matrices. Whether you can find left hand side or right hand side, the answer will always remain same. It doesn't matter whether you are multiplying B or C first, or you multiplying the A or B first. So let's multiply them together, as we will take left hand side and multiply A and B first. So for multiplying the A and B, we have to first check whether they are eligible for multiplication or not. Okay, so A, order of A is, we'll write A and B like this. Order of A is 2 into 2 and the order of B is also 2 into 2. It means their column of A and row of B are equal. It means they are suitable for multiplication. So this condition is satisfied. So we can multiply them together. So we'll multiply them as AB is equals to, A is 1, 2, 1, 2 and B is 2, 1, 1, 2. Okay, we will use the method of dot product, as we're multiplying this row with this column first. We'll write 1 into 2 plus 1 into 1 and then again this row with this column. Write 1 into 1 plus 1 into 2. Okay, then this row with this column will be 2 into 2 plus 2 into 1 and this row with this column, it will be 2 into 1 plus 2 into 2. Okay, we will solve them as AB is equals to 2 plus 1 is 3, then 1 into 1 is 1, 1 plus 2 into 1 is 2, so 1 plus 2 is 3. Again, 2 into 2 is 4 and 2 into 1 is 2. 4 plus 2 is 6, 2 into 1 is 2, 2 into 2 is 4, 2 plus 4 is 6. So this is the multiplication of A and B. Now, we have to multiply this result with the C. Okay, it means you have to multiply this result with the C. C is 1, 3, 2, 1. Again, you have to check whether the column of AB is equal to this, to the rows of C. So yes, AB is 2 into 2 and the matrix C is also 2 into 2. Okay, and there its column and its rows are equal. It means they are suitable for multiplication. So we will multiply them as AB, write as, again, we will multiply this row with this column. So 3 into 1 plus 3 into 3. Okay, then this row with this column, 3 into 2 plus 3 into 1. Okay, then this row with this column. Okay, we write 6 into 1 plus 6 into 3, then this row with this column. But we will get 6 into 2 plus 6 into 1. So we simplify it as 3 into 1 plus 3 into 3. 3 into 1 is 3, and 3 into 3 is 9. 9 plus 3 is 12, and 3 into 2 is 6, and 3 into 1 is 3. So 6 plus 3 is 9. 6 into 1 is 6, and 6 into 3 is 18. 18 plus 6 is 24. 6 into 2 is 12. 12 plus 6 is 18. So this is the result of multiplying A, B, and C together. That is A, B into C. Okay. So this is how you can multiply the three matrices together. The same formula will be applied if you use the right hand side, in which you have to multiply B and C first, and then the result will be multiplied with A. So this was all about how you can multiply the three matrices. Thank you. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel math.com for more updates. Thank you.